R. P L E A S E. Number, please. This portion of Number, Please is brought to you by Johnson Shampoo, the no-tears shampoo that can't burn eyes. And now here's your host on Number, Please, Bud Collier.
Thank you very much. Welcome to Number, Please. Either I have grown or that curtain is lower. I can't figure out which. But in any event, welcome to you two nice ladies. Nice to have you here with us. By way of introduction, ladies and gentlemen, at my immediate left is Mrs. Catherine Secord, whom we met briefly yesterday, of Trenton, New Jersey. At her left is Mrs. Helen DeWitt of Palo Alto, California. Let's say. Secord, we just barely got to chat to you.
Yes,
we did find
we
out
did.
That you had two children, though, right?
Yes, I do. I have two sons.
Nine and a half and two?
Yes.
Nine and a half and two.
Yes.
And then you're married to the biggest boy of all, and he...
Yes.
He does what?
He's a truck driver.
Where?
Over the road, and he goes out, well, this week
he... long distance hauling?
Yes, long distance.
I see. Uh-huh. Keeps him away from home a good deal, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
That's not too much fun, I'm sure.
No, sometimes it isn't.
I see a little something here about stock car racing. I don't know whether that involves you or your husband or both of you, as it does in some cases. Tell me about that. Both of you?
Both of us, yes. Mm-hmm. We got interested in it about 11 years ago, and my husband started driving first, and then when a woman's race came up, he said, well, try it. So I did, and I've been racing for about 5-6 years now. Mm-hmm.
What is a woman's race as differentiated from a man's? Is that a race where you don't have to put your hand out, you can cut across in front of it?
Yes, you can. You don't
Oh, look at the look I'm getting from Mrs. DeWitt over there. And probably from all the women drivers all over the country. I have great respect for him, as a matter of fact. I don't think it's a toss-up. I see just as many mistakes and errors and lack of courtesies in the part of men as they do in the part of women. I don't think it makes any difference at all. I do find one thing, maybe I'm wrong, and all you ladies can pounce on this one if you want to, but I find there's a great tendency among women when they're coming up to make a turn to the right to swing out more than a man does. You know, a man will go into a turn and turn more, but a woman has a tendency to swing out. Do you find that, Don Elliott? He does. He finds it, too. Miss DeWitt's won herself, let me see, 4 rounds of prizes so far. And that means you have defeated 2 opponents. You must defeat your opponent twice, you see, in order to go on, as you know, to meet another one. Other than that, we just start a game up on that game board of ours with 3 free ones to each of you. Then you guess numbers alternately. And if one of you thinks you have the right to press that little buzzer in front of you there, and that lets me know what you think you know. We'll take a moment now and let you catch your breath. Have a little story for all of you entitled, what? No More Tangles, No More Tears. Watch.
He's two. Happy, wildly. How come? The suds. When these suds get in his eyes, they can't burn eyes. So no more tears, Mother, because this is Johnson's, the No More Tears shampoo. And Mother, did you know that Gentle Johnson's now has a new formula that means not only no more tears, but no more tangles? This lady, she's 10. Pretty? Obviously. See what Johnson's new formula does for her delicate hair. Keeps it beautifully in place, soft and shining, lovely. Even after mussing, tangles just don't tangle. Johnson's actually encourages the natural tendency of hair to curl and curl and curl. So for soft, shining hair the gentle way, with no more tangles, no more tears, get Johnson's shampoo, now in non-break plastic, too.
You know what that means to the little ones in your house, especially when the hair is long, hangs down the eyes. Be able to assure them no more tangles, no more tears. That's Johnson shampoo. And you can assure them. Hope you got some. If you haven't, get it. They'll love you for it. From now on, shampoos will be fun. Okay, ladies, you ready?
Ready.
Shake hands with each other. Wish each other luck.
Good
Come
luck.
Out smiling those pretty smiles. And away we go. Light up the game board. 19 numbers in both rows, meaning, of course, beneath those numbers are 19 letters and or spaces. Mrs. DeWitt, what 3 would you like?
2, 3, 4.
She's a consistent one, this one. 2, 3, and 4 in the top row for an A, an M, and a B. And for you, Mrs. Secord?
2, 3, 4.
2, 3, and 4. If it works for one, why not for all? O-T-T, a double T there. And this game, we will begin with you, Mrs. Secord. What is your first number, please?
Number 7.
Number 7. Very well, ma'am. Why? Back to Mrs. DeWitt. What will you have?
6.
6 in the top row for an O. And now, Mrs. Secord?
10.
10. Very well. 10 is an O. Upstairs again to Mrs. DeWitt.
7, please.
7 in the top row, space. First one for either of you this game. Mrs. Secord, what now?
13.
13 it shall be. Space for you. All right, Mrs. DeWitt.
Eight, please.
Number eight in the top row starts a word with the letter C. And we go now to Mrs. Secord's row.
15.
15 in that row brings an I to light. Two O's, two T's, an I, and a Y. And you have no two of anything, I guess, so far. Mrs. DeWitt, what will you add?
10.
10. Very well, ma'am. R. Mrs. Secord.
18.
In the bottom row, number 18 is called for and given with an E. Mrs. DeWitt.
11.
11. Yes, ma'am. Next to that R comes an N. Now, Mrs. Secord.
14.
14 in the bottom row to begin a word with the letter D. And to you, Mrs. DeWitt.
13.
13. Top row, H. All right, Mrs. Secord, what now?
Six.
Six. Very well. In front of the Y comes an R. And we're back in your area, Mrs. DeWitt. What can we do for you?
14.
14 it shall be. O. H-O. Mrs. Secord.
12.
Number 12. Ends a word with the letter N. Mrs. DeWitt, what now?
Five.
Five. The number five is called for, bringing a double O there. And Mrs. Secord, you have a double T. What will you have?
Number nine.
Number nine. Very well. In front of that O, a C. And Mrs. DeWitt?
15.
15. Top L. Mrs. Secord?
Number 19.
19. Bottom, ending your row with the letter S. Mrs. DeWitt?
17.
17. Top row, E. Mrs. Secord?
Number 8.
8. In the bottom row, space between words. And Mrs. DeWitt?
19.
Number 19 it shall be. Lending your O with an S also. Mrs. Secord?
Number 5.
Number 5 in your row, E. Mrs. DeWitt?
12.
12. Top, space. Mrs. Secord?
17.
17. Bottom, H. Mrs. DeWitt? Oh, got a guess coming from Mrs. DeWitt. As before, Mrs. DeWitt, each time I've warned you, and I will again, that your guess must be, of course, letter for letter, exactly as we have it up there. Deviate in even so much as one letter, and you throw a free guess to your opponent. What is your guess on that top row?
I'll say bamboo corn holders.
Say it again, please.
Bamboo corn holders.
Bamboo corn holders. Let's see if it's right. It is right. And you're halfway there. And the bottom row?
Pottery corn dishes.
Repeat it again, please.
Pottery corn dishes.
Pottery corn dishes. If it lights, it's right. It does, and it is. That game went sucking right down the wire there. We had only, I think, three blanks left in each row. Allow us to see.
Are you watching, you little rascals?
Oh, it's fun, isn't it?
And who subscribes to it?
Go on. Push the button.
Think of the fun you could have on
the tube.
The tube.
You.
Tube.
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 TV tubes.
That's a lot of fun, isn't it?
It's going to be a lot more fun
if you keep going the way you're going.
Go on. Push the button.
Please subscribe. Subscribe.
I hope they're watching.